Kowski.
Thank you, Madam Chairman. Administrator, thank you for being here today. I came in as Senator Landrieu was asking questions about the mapping and the quality of the mapping. I hear so much about this from my constituents, and I know because I've shared some of their concerns with you. But whether they're the local governments, whether they're the individual homeowners, what they're complaining about is what they perceive to be the quality of the data that FEMA relies on, that ultimately forces those homeowners to pay for the flood insurance premiums. And they're looking at these maps, and they're saying these are illogical, they're inaccurate. And then FEMA comes back and it says, well, hire yourself an engineer, get an elevation certificate, file file for a LOMA if you don't like it. And of course, that just further infuriates them because they figure, look, you should have gotten the facts right in the first place rather than to have them pay for something that they don't necessarily want. So the question to you this afternoon is whether or not the act that we have passed has provided FEMA with any new tools to improve the quality of maps so that we can get it right the first time. Because I think that's what people are hoping for, is that we're going to get it right the first time. So do we have a better way to do this?
Yes, Senator. And it goes back to the way the maps are done now. They're not done house by house. They're done by areas. And they set a rate for an area, not for a house. Mm-hmm. And unless we know what the elevation of that house is, you're going to get the rate that's established for that area. So if a house has a higher elevation, that's why we need the elevation certificates. If it's above the base flood elevation, they don't have to pay the higher rates. They get a preferred rate. But the maps currently do not map the base elevation of a house. But technology is changing. And this is one of the things that Senator Landrieu has been supporting. And that is, we have funds in our budget. We're going to support the USGS. And there's some funds for USGS to look at how we do better modeling with LIDAR. And some of the techniques now get to the point where we think it's becoming economical, not just to shoot a neighborhood or an area, but actually do it house by house. But part of this is going back to, we need to validate the science behind this, make sure it's accurate and we're getting good results, because I just don't want to spend a lot of money and generate information we can't use. But we're looking at, how do we move the mapping so it's not just doing the area, but we can actually get to a pretty good idea, particularly in residential structures, what that first floor elevation is.
How soon do you see that being available?
Well, if I was talking about...
We know it's out there, but readily available.
The challenge for government is we have never been, what I would say, rapid at adapting new technology. Mm-hmm. But the good part about this is FEMA does not do the actual mapping. We contract with engineering firms. So my hope is, if we can validate the new tools, then by working with the private sector and contracting for the map development, we can partner up with work that other federal agencies are doing, as well as the new techniques to get better maps. But if you really want to get to that whole issue of, why do I have to go and get all this additional information about my home, I don't think it's that low. I need to be able to get maps that show on a residential basis what that elevation is to risk to map it.
Let me ask a couple more local to the state issues. And the first one relates to the situation in Juneau and the city and borough of Juneau's claim that they should be permitted to develop in the velocity zone because they are in a very protected position as an island community within the Inside Passage there in Southeast. But the NFIP regulations put an absolute block on development in the velocity zone. Juneau has, they acknowledge it's going to stifle their ability to develop at all. FEMA has expressed a willingness to undertake this study here, and we inserted some language in the FY14 Homeland Security Approves Bill to encourage FEMA to take a look at this issue, but we're still sitting here now a couple years out. Is there any progress that you can report on this? Is FEMA willing to work with Juneau on this?
Well, we're willing to work. I'd have to have staff respond in writing on what
could
progress.
Could you do that?
Yes, Senator.
I would appreciate that.
But this goes back to an issue that Senator Landrieu has raised. The reason we tend to want not to build in velocity zones, that is the most vulnerable area to any type of flooding. But as Senator Landrieu points out, there are sometimes infrastructure or greater interest. That means we have to find a way to balance the risk versus the needs of the community. And
well,
I think that's the direction we're trying to go in.
And again, this is an issue that apparently there was some willingness by FEMA to look at it. We've encouraged that, and we just haven't seen any further progress. And I know that this is something that we would like to try to address. I wanted to ask one brief question on Galena. So, you know, we had a major flooding in Galena last year. This is my first opportunity to talk to you since we've dealt with that disaster, and the IG has issued his report on FEMA's experience. The IG concluded, as I had, that working in a remote Native community like Galena posed some unique challenges for FEMA, whether it's policy issues, logistics, or the cultural. And as we look to application of the NFIP on a community like Galena, I think it becomes clear to me that it just wasn't set up to deal with a remote Indian community where people live a subsistence lifestyle on their ancestral Native lands. And I guess my question to you is whether or not you think it makes sense to perhaps revisit whether these flood insurance laws should operate differently in some communities like Galena. We're going to be having a hearing in Indian Affairs next week on the broader subject about lessons learned from that, but it's clear to me that we need to do more to improve disaster response in some of these areas. So if you'd care to comment.
Yes, Senator, I'll break this into two pieces. Quite honestly, on the flood insurance, that would be something new to look at. On the response side, we have been looking at the IG reports, your concerns. We are updating and redesigning our policy when we're dealing in these types of situations. We've also been revamped our tribal consultation policy, right, which we think was part of the inherent issues that we were not, although we are now recognizing tribal governments under the Stafford Act for disaster assistance directly. The consultation policy was only recently updated, as well as the declaration policy, the draft policy we're working from. So we have been working on this from the standpoint of responding to your concerns in the IG by updating and changing our response policy. And that is nearing completion as we do that pilot, as well as our consultation. We will take the flood insurance as well and put that into our consultation process and begin that work.
Well, we may wish to have further discussion about the lessons learned from Galena. And then if you can get me information on the Juneau velocity zone, I'd appreciate it. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Senator. And let me put up my favorite map again and ask FEMA, would you please produce a map for Alaska that looks just like this?
Yes, Senator. Hawaii. We can do it for all of the territories and for...
And the territories,
yes,
and Alaska, because Alaska will take up half of the geographic space of the lower 48, and it deserves its own map. So we're going to get...
Thank you, Madam Chairman.
You're welcome. You're going to get your own map, and Hawaii is going to get its own map, because... You know, we really have to be careful with this.